I tend to draw a few hairs in and lose them. And drop some shadows on. Now, here in the shadow area, I'm going to put a lot of blue on before I put the green. Okay, brown for the eyes. Just the nostrils. A bit of a warm shadow that side, and then fill in this area. And then add some warm tones on the side of the face. Even though it's white, it's still got some lovely reflective light on there. Near the side of the chin. Now, if you know your colour theory, and everyone does, that yellow and blue make green, so I tend to put some yellow underneath the green to give it a bit more vibrancy, like so. So when I come back with blue on top, I can actually control how green the green is. And as you can observe, as I bring the blue on top, it turns magically to green, but still retains the kind of lively green that I want. Because within the green, there are reflected areas, and you leave a bit of a lighter green, almost yellow showing through, and that gives you a greater depth than just using a flat green. Yeah. Not sure if that will come across on the video, because some of these shirts look better in real life than they do on screen, but I think you're going to get the point I'm trying to make. Okay, go over the black again till it's nice and dense, and then start adding the highlights. Dot in the eye, that side. Dot in the eye, that side. The corner of the eye, there. Add some white to the shiny part of the white of the eye. Then add some white there. The top of the lid, there's a very broken up line, corner of the eye, break it off a bit, corner, right, and this part of the white of the eye there. Corner of the eye. Just keep going backwards and forwards until it springs to life, which it will do if you follow all the stages and apply yourself. Now here, don't get too mad. You want to sort of dry brush this top edge like so, and then in that crease there's also some reflection. Again, all these are things you've got to look, take a step back and see from a distance. Drop a bit of white there, and damp it down here. This is where the Peter's so complicated, because towards the end there's a lot of highlights you've got to get spot on. But when it comes to life, it suddenly springs to life, and you really see the lightness, you know. Now, there's little dots of, like, I don't know, glistening, I wouldn't say sweat, but reflective points there. This line, put this in nice and bright. And on the bottom lip, again like the others, there's a line of highlight which really brings the lips to life. And like I did with the Freely, here just add a little touch, add an earring, it's just simply a line like that. And it just brings it to life, and then add a highlight on the front of the dangly earring. And all of a sudden, all these little bits start to come together. Don't rush this bit, because it's a classic case of less is more. Okay, when you nearly finished this section here, like on the jean one, get a bit of dry brush and then add some scumble to that crease, and then the same on the other side. These are the little touches that really finish this t-shirt off. But don't make it too chalky, just a touch. So after you've added the white and got over the black, you should end up with a t-shirt that looks like this. And as I say, this isn't really a beginner's t-shirt, it's more intermediate. So if you want to have a go yourself, do Paul first, then Jean or Ace, and leave Peter to last unless you're feeling really ambitious. Alternatively, go to my eBay shop, Nick Smith World, ebay.co.uk. And you can purchase this shirt or one very much like it, painted by me using the same stencil. So until the next time, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this. Bye.